So you guys already know what time it is. It's time for Featuring You, episode 9. I'm almost running out of fingers with how many episodes there are. So, let's do it. What's going on, guys? Car Mechanic here, and I was actually just watching episode 8 of Featuring You, and I realized I was wearing the same t-shirt. Now, I don't want to go and change. As with each Featuring You, every video has a theme, and the theme for this month is card cheating or gambling. Now, I've had a lot of great entries, and unfortunately, I can't put them all in, but all you guys will be shouted out at the end of this video, and the links to all of everyone's channels will be down in the description below, including the three people that I have featured in this video. So, I think we're ready to get started. Now, first up, I have 7 Cents Magic here. I've actually done a collab with them in the past, so you guys really need to check out this performance because it's just insane how cleanly his card handling is. Check it out.
Hi, so I hope you're all doing great, and I'd like to show you something a little bit different, okay? You know, personally, I'm not very much interested in card games, but since playing cards are primarily used for gambling, I'd like to show you something in that regard, and it's important in the sense that should teach you why you should never gamble with strangers. You know, one of the most direct ways in which a cheater can actually gain an advantage over the opponent is actually by controlling cards. Now, if he can control at least one card, then he will have an advantage over the opponent. So, I'd like to show you how a cheater can actually control the card and what he could possibly accomplish using it if he has enough skill. So, to demonstrate this, I'll actually need your help. Okay, I want you to name any 4 of a kind. Let's say, for example, the 4 tens, okay? So what I will do is I will take out the cards, but keep in mind that in an actual situation, cheater will never actually take out the cards just like I'm doing right now. The spotting actually happens after a previous game when the cards are all face up, and from there on, he would simply keep track of them. But since we are not in an actual situation, we will do it this way. Also, another thing is that cheater will never actually need to control 4 cards, you know. He might at the most need maybe 3 cards to make sure that he will end up with the most money by the end of the day. But in this case, since we are already demonstrating, we will use 4 cards, okay? So what I will do is I will bury the tens in different parts of the deck, okay? So that they are all scattered throughout, okay? And as you can see, they are all going in different parts, okay, separated. And obviously, the more cards that need to be controlled, the more difficult it actually gets. And as I said, to control 4 cards is something that a cheater will never actually attempt. But in this case, I'll give it a try, okay? So, if you are going to casinos, you might have actually seen the dealer there shuffle like this. And after the shuffle, he might give something called the strip, okay? And after this, he is actually required to give it one straight cut. Now, sometimes, on a good day, I could cut to one of those tens. But on a very good day, I could cut to all 4 of those tens. So that is how you control the card, but obviously controlling the cards just to the top of the deck is not very good enough, because at this point, if I deal out, these cards will actually go to different players, and that is why I actually have to reposition them so that when I deal, it actually falls for myself, or even better, it actually falls to one of my partners. And that's what magicians call stacking the deck. You know, gamblers call it running up a hand, but let's just call it cheating, okay? So what I would do is I will try to stack these 4 tens to my partner, let's say the second player, okay? So we'll just start from the scratch, okay? We will bury the tens in different parts, and we will just assume that we have 6 players. Now, the last time I shuffled, my intentions were to stack the cards, but sorry, to control the cards, but in this case, it's a little bit more complicated than that. So, but anyway, I will try, okay? And notice that the shuffles are actually fair shuffles, okay? I don't know whether you can actually see this, but the shuffles are actually fair. And of course, after the shuffle, the deck has to be cut, right? And so at this point, I can actually deal out the cards. And I said the six standard game, right? So, and you wanted the tens, and that's what you get. And notice that every card is being dealt fairly off top of the deck, but I can still deal that 10. Now that's because I shuffled unfairly. By the way, I don't want you to misunderstand. The guy with the 10s is actually not my partner, okay? He's the sucker who's gonna lose everything, including his tie. Because my real partner is over here, sitting with the 4 kings. But you know what? I never trust my partner. That's why I always double cross him by dealing myself the 4 aces.
I mean, did you see how clean that was? Hands down, fantastic performance. Make sure to leave a like for him. So up next, we have Magic Tricks 51. And at the time of this recording, this guy is at like 984 subscribers, I think. So like that close to 1K. And I know how exciting that is because at like, I think 998, 999, I was just sitting there in front of the computer. Oh, we're almost there. We're almost there. And then eventually I missed it because I fell asleep, but it's exciting regardless. So anyway, I think he did a fantastic performance and I hope this will help propel him forward to 1,000 subscribers if he didn't get there already by the time this is published. So check him out.
Hello everyone, MagicTricks51 here, and here is my trick. So here I have a normal dice as well as a normal deck of cards. As you see here, they are all different and all in fact mixed up. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to spread through the cards like this, and here I have the dice, and I'm going to hand it to the spectators so they can roll it. So let's see what they land on here. 4, alright, so we're going to count 4 cards off the top of the deck. 1, 2, 3, and 4. The fourth card is right here. I won't look at it, I'll place it right there. We'll put away this dice since we do not need it and collect the cards. And now I'm going to turn this deck into 4 piles, 2 facing up and 2 facing down, just as you see here, like that. And now I'm going to take the first 2 piles, 1 facing up and 1 facing down, and ripple shuffle them together just like that, creating a mess of cards face up and face down. I'm going to ripple shuffle this pack to this pack here. Alright, so we'll go ahead and do that. Like that, and then I'll finally ripple shuffle it to the last pack here, just like that, creating a big mess of face up and face down cards. All right, now I want you to imagine for a second that all those cards there fix themselves, but a certain amount of cards don't. Watch, it's happened just like this. As you see, there's certain cards face up. I'm gonna go ahead and remove those cards while I spread here. We have an ace of spades, a queen of spades, a jack of spades, as well as a 10 of spades here. And I remove them, and if you look at them, they're actually almost a royal flush, but we're missing one card. It's the king. But remember, there's one card here, and it happens to be the king of spades to make a perfect royal flush. So that is my trick. Hopefully you guys did all enjoy it. That is it.
I mean, come on, that was pretty good. I was wondering the entire time, where is he going with this? And at the end, didn't expect that royal flush. So that was pretty cool. Awesome job. Now to wrap this all up, we have Jay McCain. And the question I asked myself when picking his entry was, does he have the skill set it takes to be a great magician? And I think he does. I really think he does. Can his skills be refined? Absolutely. But I think the foundation is definitely there. So let's check out his video.
Today, I'm going to show you why you should never play cards with a magician. To begin with, a magician can take a deck of cards and can cut to whatever cards they desire. For example, the 4 aces. Now, if I take the aces and just lose them back into the pack, just like so, and I can even give the pack a couple of cards just to completely lose them. The next reason you should never play cards with a magician is that a magician knows the location of every single card, and I will now relocate the 4 aces. I think I'm going to go with these 4. Yeah. If I take them, there they are, the 4 aces. Now we no longer actually need the aces, so I can Just go ahead and lose them into the deck and give the pack a few cards. For the next reason, I need four cards, let's say the four sevens. You have one, two, three, and four. The four sevens. And I'm just going to set them down on the table right there where you can see them for the whole trick. Now, the next reason you should never play cards with a magician is that a magician can manipulate a deck of cards without you even noticing. Just like that. Four cards have turned face down in the center of the deck. Now, these aren't just any four cards. They are the one, two, three, and four sevens. Now, if they're the four sevens, I'm sure you're wondering what these cards over here are. Well, that leads us to the final reason you should never play cards with a magician. When playing poker, a magician will never settle for a hand worse than a royal flush. Thank you for watching.
And that's all I have for this month's featuring you. The links to all these guys' channels that were featured will be in the description, and I'm sure you can find them easily. And I do want to give a couple of shout outs to everyone that entered, because without you guys entering, this video would not be possible. So the people that entered also had fantastic entries. We have Art of Cards, Crazy Card Tricks, Card Magic, and TM Magician. You guys are awesome. The real MVPs right there. We'll have a link to your channels in the description as well. So make sure you guys go and check them out. Now, for those of you guys who have not seen the first 8 episodes, I'll put the playlist right there. You guys can go check them out, and I'll see you there. Peace out.